What's up, guys? In the works, and today we're doing an underused weapons, and it's with the G3A3. And there's been an overwhelming majority of you guys who've wanted me to do another video with the G3A3. Now, I've talked about in the past that I don't really feel like it's underused, it's just kind of underappreciated. I've done a few videos where I kind of talk about that. But a lot of you guys really want to see it in this particular series. And I know a lot of people get upset when they watch these and they want to say, oh, this isn't underused, they see it all the time. You know, Jake, you have so many weapons in this series that at some point you got to realize it's not underused. Listen, guys, the point of this series isn't so much that it's, quote, underused, you know, it's never used. It's just to look at some more weapons, to look at weapons that a lot of people don't ever consider using. I think the G3 is one of them. I think the G3 often gets overlooked. You know, it does have a low rate of fire. 550, that's really on the low end. I mean, it's up there with like the M60. It makes it kind of difficult to use. I mean, the fact that it also only has a 20 round magazine really kind of limits what you can do with it as well. So a lot of people overlook this weapon, and that's kind of the point of this series. But I wanted to revisit the G3A3 in this particular series because a lot of people have requested it, and it was one of the first episodes I ever did. If you go back and look at the underused weapons series, you'll see that it started with like the SG553, the G53, the QBZ95, and then the G3A3. Those are some of my pilot episodes where I kind of kicked this series off. And I wanted to revisit it a little bit because I've done plenty of videos with the G3. There's no doubt about that. If you go and look at the handful of videos I've done an assault sniper video, which is actually really cool, where I put a bipod and a high zoom scope on it using heavy barrel, and I snipe people on single fire, so it's kind of that assault sniper. And I had a lot of fun with that. And I also did a video talking about why it's kind of underappreciated, and I still kind of stand by that logic. I don't really necessarily feel like this weapon's, quote, underused at all times. I mean, it's often overlooked by a lot of people. People don't really appreciate it. And like I said, that's kind of the notion of this series, is to get you to out there using some different weapons, getting an idea of how some of these other weapons work, because a lot of people tend to grasp onto one weapon and never seem to let go. And the G3 has always been really intriguing to me. I've always liked the idea of a high damage weapon like the G3. And since I've actually done the first G3A3 underused weapons video, it's actually been patched since then. So that weapon, you know, that little weapon showcase might be a little outdated. So I thought it would be time to put this into the underused weapons category, because it is now a 34 damage weapon and it drops off to a 22 damage weapon. So in almost every scenario, you're looking at a 5 bullet kill. I mean, even from extreme long ranges, you're looking at a 5 bullet kill. Now, one of the things that I think puts a lot of people off to the G3 is the fact that it does have substantial recoil. But it's not uncontrollable. It's definitely manageable if you know what you're doing. Oftentimes, I don't fire more than like 3 bursts. Like, I'll fire off 3 rounds out of my magazine and I'll let go. And I'll fire 3 rounds and I'll let go. And it's almost like I'm using a burst fire weapon. And a lot of people see that and they're like, well, you can control the recoil, you can pull down it on a little bit. But I found that with the 20 rounds, that makes it a lot harder. And you'll burn through ammo much quicker if you do it like that. So oftentimes you'll even see me using single fire. This is one of the few weapons that I use single fire, just because it is so accurate if you just sit there and pop shots at people. And it's not hard to get headshots with this thing. If you do it right, if you control your recoil, you can be very successful with this particular weapon. But one of the things you guys always want me to talk about is, which attachments do I think work well with these weapons? Well, in the past, the G3A3 has always been heavy barrel or die. It really does benefit from the increased accuracy, the increased bullet velocity that you get from using it, and that's a huge benefit, guys, especially the bullet velocity, because this is a very low bullet velocity weapon. I think it only shoots 500 meters per second. So combo that with the fact that heavy barrel, you hold your damage a little bit longer at range, you've got a pretty attractive choice. I mean, it's hard to say no to the heavy barrel, but if you're struggling with the recoil on this thing, because it is quite wild, one of the best alternatives I've learned is actually the flash suppressor. It does kind of tame that recoil a little bit. It really only hurts you up close. You know, it's not going to penalize you at range. You're still going to have the base accuracy of the G3, so the flash suppressor is definitely a viable option if you're struggling with the recoil. But hopefully you guys did enjoy this quick little look at the G3A3. I did want to revisit it because I thought it deserved a second little appearance here on the underused weapons, since it was one of the founding fathers. But if you did enjoy it, be sure to leave a like, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.